So in this video, we're going to talk about a junction potential, which I alluded to in a couple previous lectures about the silver-silver chloride and the calomel electrodes. So first, let's define junction potential. And this is a potential that's usually worth a few millivolts. And it's going to arise when two different electrolytic solutions are placed in contact. So, of course, we're dealing with two aqueous solutions in many of these potentiometry and voltaic cell type setups. So, for example, if you have electrolytic solution where positive charge is migrating faster, and there's a positive end of the solution, and the negative charge will separate from that because of different mobilities, then you get this charge separation, aka a voltage or a potential that arises. And when we place two different electrolytic solutions in contact, these charge separations are going to arise due to differential mobilities of the electrolytes in the solution. Or it has to do with how they well they travel based on the voltage within the solution. So sometimes you'll have the cations traveling faster, other times the anions migrate faster, but whenever they are dissimilar or not equal, then you'll get a charge separation. And this charge separation is going to occur at either end of the salt bridge that's connecting the two dissimilar electrolytic solutions. So the problem here is that when this voltage exists, this is going to cause the reading of E cell, which your potentiometer tells you, to differ from reality. Or it will cause inaccuracies in the voltage measurement, and then you get inaccurate concentrations and chemical information. So mobility tells us about sort of the ability of a charge molecule to travel in two dimensions in an electric field. And mobility, we've seen as mu earlier in this course. It's generally a length squared per volt times second. So this voltage is of course dependent upon the potential between the reference and indicator solutions or the cathode and anode solutions. But if this mobility significantly differs for two ions, then we get this charge separation leading to inaccuracies in concentration or chemical information type measurements. So let me explain a salt or an ion pair that does not work well and causes great inaccuracies, and then we'll discuss what the solution is. So sodium and chloride are both anions, but sodium is smaller and chloride has a larger valence shell. So we could say that because they have the same amount of charge but different volumes, sodium is more charge dense. And chloride is more charge dispersed. So because sodium is more charge dense, in water, it's not going to sit by itself. It's going to interact with some partial negative charge that it can find in the solution. And that partial negative charge is going to be the oxygen of the water molecule. So several water molecules will solvate or hydrate this sodium ion to create this hydration sphere. And now, because it's very hydrated or very solvated due to that high charge density, it's going to be effectively heavier. Because when sodium migrates, it has to drag all these water molecules with it. So chloride is more charge dispersed, which means actually it will attract a smaller number of these water molecules, where chloride bonds or has an ion dipole type interaction with the proton of water, the positively charged end. So there are fewer water molecules. Let me exaggerate that and delete a couple of these. So it's still solvated, but less solvated, because it didn't have as much charge per unit volume. So it's lighter. And therefore, chloride will have a higher mobility, or it will travel through solution at a higher velocity, depending upon the electric field. And the sodium will have a lower mobility as it drags more water molecules along with it as it travels. So if you were to place a sodium chloride solution into pure deionized water, then the chloride and sodium in the solution are going to move from regions of high concentration to low concentration. And as sodium travels, it's traveling slower than the chloride. So on average, the chloride molecule or atoms are going to be further ahead, and the sodium are going to form this positively rich layer, while the chloride form this negatively rich layer. And anytime we separate charge, because the differential mobilities of these ions, that's going to create a junction potential. That's usually a few millivolts, as I mentioned, but it's going to cause inaccuracies for your measurement of concentration for the electrolytes that you do care about measuring the concentration of. So we ideally want to minimize this junction potential. It's impossible to really make it zero, but we can minimize it by using potassium chloride. Potassium chloride have similar hydration spheres and similar mobilities. Which means that we'll have very little charge separation because those ions are going to migrate at about the same rate. So, for more practice with junction potential, you can visit the multiple choice in unit 4, or in other words, the electrochemistry unit of my analytical course guide. And that's available at chemguides.com.